गुड इवनिंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न टू मेथड्स ऑफ सेपरेटिंग अ मिक्सचर। दिस टू मेथड आर द डेस्टिलेशन एंड फ्रैक्शनल डेस्टिलेशन। सो व्हेन दिस डेस्टिलेशन एंड फ्रैक्शनल डेस्टिलेशन आर यूजफुल, व्हाई द मिक्सचर cannot be separated by using the other method and we need this fractional distillation. So what is the characteristic required for fractional distillation and distillation? Okay, so those things we will learn. These two are exclusively used for miscible liquids. We have already learned if the liquids are immiscible, means they are not intermixing, then that can be separated by separating funnel. But if the liquids are miscible, means they are able to mix with each other, they are not present in separate layer, then this have to be separated by either distillation or fractional distillation. So this thing we have to keep in mind, it is used for miscible liquids mixture. Again, if they are miscible, then what is difference between this distillation and fractional distillation? Okay, student, it is this thing that we are going to learn. Students, just recall all the concepts that we have learned in other methods. We have already finished sedimentation, filtration, evaporation, sublimation, centrifugation, separating funnel, chromatography, and crystallization in our earlier classes. So we are left with only these two things we are going to discuss today. A student, you shall must keep in mind all the above method, means all the 8 methods, they were very simple. Okay? And there were certain specific characteristic on which these methods were based. Now let us understand about the distillation. A student, we have learned about vaporization or evaporation, where if a mixture is heated, then one of the component get converted into vapor. That was the requirement for evaporation. But what if both the component are vaporizing together? At that time, this distillation and fractional distillation come into picture. Okay, student. So this distillation basically consists of the two things. One is called vaporization or evaporation, and next is called condensation. So it is the combination of the two. Let us start with this distillation. So students, this distillation consists of two processes. One is your vaporization or evaporation. Basically, vaporization is the better term because we are giving the heat to convert it into vapor. So it is called as vaporization. After this vaporization, both the liquid gets converted into vapor, then they are cooled. That cooling is called condensation. So vaporization and condensation both are occurring in the same process called distillation. Okay, for this we need an arrangement or mechanism in which in one part vaporization occur and in other part this condensation occur. A student, if you recall this vaporization, what was this vaporization? Vaporization means you are heating something to get converted into the vapor. So it is the process of heating of liquid. heating of liquid mixture. While the liquid mixture is heated, then it will form the vapor. So while heating the liquid mixture, vapor or both the liquids are formed, or even just one of the liquid is formed. Vapor of one of the component, let us take one of the component. If both are going to form the vapor, then we have to use the fractional distillation. That only makes the difference. So vapor of one of the component rises, then this vapor of one of the component have to be cooled. So that process of cooling the vapor to get back the liquid is called condensation. So condensation is the process of, it is the process of cooling of liquid, sorry, of vapor, not the liquid or liquid vapor, of the vapor, so that it will get condensed back, so that it gets converted into liquid. So liquid from vapor is obtained. A student, it is very simple if you just understand these two processes. So the process that is going to occur in distillation is first heating, then cooling. Write it. In distillation, first the liquid mixture is heated. Are you getting these points? So first the liquid mixture will be heated, so that one of the component will get vaporizes. Then the vapor formed is cooled back to get the liquid. And this liquid is collected into other vessel. So it is collected into other vessel. While the vessel containing the mixture of different component, so this vessel will remain with only one of the component which have not vaporizes. So right here, so not vaporizing, vaporizing component remain in the heating flask, in the, so either heating flask or distillating flask, okay, in that it will remain. So how is this process? Now let us come back to this figure. A student, whatever the process I have explained, so you will take the mixture in a flask or in an heating apparatus. So a student, observe it carefully. So whatever this you are going to take, observe this. This is the extent. Are you getting? So here we have a flask. Observe this. This is the flask. Getting? Here the mixture is taken. This mixture is nothing but it is mixture of alcohol and water, or acetone and water. So where this method can be used, this can be used for those liquid which are miscible. That is important. For miscible means two mixable liquid, but the two mixable liquid have slightly different boiling point, that I had already told you. If the boiling point of two different miscible liquid is more than 30 degrees C, then only one of the component will vaporize while the other will remain in this flask. So this, in this flask, we have taken this acetone and the water. Okay, student? So write down the example. Acetone or alcohol and water mixture, or acetone, alcohol or acetone, both are nearly the same kind of thing. Acetone you are absorbing. Have you absorbed the nail polish or the thinner?
Yes, sir.
Yes, that contains this acetone. And
sir, alcohol does not vaporize.
Alcohol will vaporize. You just observe what I am writing. So if the mixture is like this one, alcohol is mixed with water, or acetone is mixed with water, then you will observe that alcohol and acetone are not collected in different layer in water, rather they remain mixed with water. Like we have observed, if you add the, or if you mix the kerosene oil in water, then kerosene oil is going to form a separate layer and water is going to form a separate layer. So these two separate layer can be drained by using separating funnel. But if we are mixing this alcohol with water, then no two separate layer is obtained. So such a liquid in which these two components have mixed together, no separate layer is formed. So this such a mixture is called as miscible liquid. Okay, student? So these are miscible liquid mixture. So for the miscible liquid mixture, one of the component have different boiling point than the other. If you take the acetone have the boiling point nearly 60 or 70, while the water have the boiling point of, while the water have the boiling point of 100 degrees C. So because of difference in their boiling point, these two liquid get vaporizes at different temperature. So right, one thing is miscible liquid and they have different boiling point. Since they have different boiling point, the important thing is that their boiling point BP difference should be at least 30 degrees C, or the boiling point difference should be greater than 30 degrees C. This is the requirement. Okay? So if you are taking the boiling point is what the temperature of water, and if you are taking the boiling point, means it is the boiling point for acetone, this difference is greater than 30 degrees C. That's why this method is suitable. You are already knowing this is around 100 degrees C. Okay, student? And if you take this acetone, it is around 60 degrees C. Exactly, it is 56 degrees. Okay? So it is 60 degrees C. Now, what is the difference? 100 minus 60 degrees. So this is 40 degrees C. Are you getting? This difference is greater than 30 degrees C. Therefore, the method of fractional distillation can be used, which is greater than 30 degrees C. This implies fractional distillation can be used.
Fractional distillation.
Yeah, normal distillation. Even fractional distillation may be used, but keep in mind here normal distillation is used. If the difference is less than 30 degrees C, then we have to especially go for the fractional distillation. So fractional distillation is applicable everywhere, but no need of here fractional distillation. So write it the distillation basically. So the Distillation is used. So the process of distillation can be used for those liquid whose boiling point difference is greater than 30 degrees. ये आपको ध्यान में रखना है. Like acetone and water, alcohol and water, and these two liquids are miscible. ये चीजें आपको ध्यान में रखनी है. यदि इमिसिबल है तो हम सेपरेटिंग फनल यूज कर लेंगे, बट यदि ये मिसिबल है यानी यदि वो सेपरेट लेयर नहीं फॉर्म कर रहे हैं तब हमें डेस्टिलेशन यूज करने पड़ते हैं. बट अगेन डेस्टिलेशन में हमें ये ध्यान में रखना पड़ता है कि इनके जो बॉइलिंग पॉइंट का डिफरेंस है ये अपने को 30 डिग्री से ज्यादा है तो डेस्टिलेशन, यदि ये 30 डिग्री से कम होगा तब हमें फ्रैक्शनल डेस्टिलेशन में हम जाएंगे. सो वी विल गो फॉर द फ्रैक्शनल डेस्टिलेशन लेटर. ओके स्टूडेंट, सो हाउ इज दिस सेटअप? Now let me go for explaining this setup. Okay, student. So in this setup, we are going to take the mixture of this acetone and water, or you may take the other kind of mixture also, like your alcohol and water, mean the same thing, but in your book it is given for acetone and water. So let me take this figure from your book. So how is this arrangement? It is this one. So this is the arrangement. Or setup for which process? It is for distillation. We are talking about the distillation. So how this distillation is carried out? A student, just we have learned few things. This distillation need, the very first step is your heating arrangement or vaporization. And the second arrangement that it needs is cooling arrangement called condensation. So these two things or two process have to be carried out in the same arrangement. So a student, we are taking the mixture. Mixture is first placed in this heating flask. Are you getting this much? Okay, I have overwrite with the blue pen. So the mixture of acetone and water is placed here and it is heated with the help of burner. Okay student, what is this? This is the heating arrangement.
Burner.
Yes. Okay, this is the
we have to draw this or we can mark in textbook.
If you can draw it, then that will be convenient. और यदि mark यदि आप करना चाहते हैं तो आप कर लीजिए. और आपको यदि doubt लगता है तो देखिए मैं आप बिना figure देखे मैं पूरा draw कर करके आपको दिखाता है. You please draw with me. A student, what you have to do? You have to take a flask. Draw with me. आपको ये लगता है कि sir तो just ready made ऐसा ले लिया है करके. So we are going to just take a flask. Okay, student. इस फ्लास्क को हमें ऐसा खड़ा करने के लिए एक स्टैंड चाहिए. तो ये देखिए, दिस इज द स्टैंड. इसका सेटअप है, ये इसे टाइट करके इधर ये बोल्ट कर देता है. दिस इज द स्टैंड. ओके, सो राइट दिस, दिस इज द फ्लास्क. दिस फ्लास्क इज यूज फॉर हीटिंग और इन द प्रोसेस ऑफ डेस्टिलेशन. सो sometimes it is also called as distillation flask or distillating flask. Okay student, so in this flask we are going to take the mixture of
acetone and water.
Yes, so this is the mixture right here, mixture of miscible liquid like maybe acetone and water or alcohol and water. ओके स्टूडेंट, ड्रॉ विथ मी, मैं इसको ड्रॉ करता हूं आपके साथ. What is this arrangement? This arrangement is nothing but it is the stand or holder for this flask. Okay, student. ये होल्डर का कहने के नीचे रहेगा सो दैट दिस फ्लास्क विल रिमेन स्लाइटली अबव. नाउ व्हाट इज द फर्स्ट मेथड और द फर्स्ट प्रोसेस? द फर्स्ट प्रोसेस रिक्वायर्ड इज द हीटिंग ऑफ दिस मिक्सचर. दैट्स व्हाई दिस फ्लास्क इज केप्ट स्लाइटली अबव. नाउ द हीटिंग अरेंजमेंट इज गोइंग टू मेट हियर. सो फ्लेम वी आर गोइंग टू टेक. ओके, सो दिस इज द फ्लेम राइट हियर. This is the flame. This is the burner. So this is placed on the ground, so it will appear to be just touching this one. Okay, so this arrangement is nothing but it is the flame. Or this arrangement is the burner, which when lighted, it will start producing flame. Okay, student, it is this one. Now, while this is being heated, this mixture is going to vaporize. Since the acetone have lower boiling point, so acetone will vaporize. Or alcohol have lower boiling point than water, then alcohol will vaporize. On heating. So heating is done such that only one of the components shall vaporize while water remain in liquid phase. Remain in liquid phase. So a student, where this should be heated? The boiling point of water is 100 degrees C and acetone is nearly 60 degrees C. So a student, the temperature that should be kept is nearly 70 or 80 degrees C. So that all the acetone will vaporize or all the alcohol will vaporize, but water will not vaporize. So temperature where it is heated, so temperature is kept around 80 what? Degrees C. Yes, Darnish, tell me.
Sir, others.
हाँ दर्श बोलिए.
Why the liquid will not vaporize?
अभी आप ये देखिए कौन सा लिक्विड कब वेपोराइज होता है. देखिए आपने देखे होंगे कि घर में जब आप एक पानी को गर्म करिए और मिल्क को गर्म करिए, ठीक है, तो कौन पहले जल्दी से बॉयल होना शुरू होता है? क्या अभी आपने कभी ऑब्जर्व किया है? यू विल ऑब्जर्व मिल्क स्टार्ट बॉइलिंग अ बिट अर्ली देन वाटर. आप सेम हीट यानी आप अपने घर के स्टोव पे सेम हीट दोनों को दीजिए. एक पे आप वाटर रखिए, दूसरे पे आप मिल्क रखिए, तो आप देखेंगे मिल्क जल्दी बॉयल करना शुरू हो जाता है. बॉयल करने का मीनिंग है कि वो वेपर फेज में कन्वर्ट होना शुरू हो जाएगा. उसका सिंपल यही मीनिंग है, यानी कि वो नीचे से वो लिक्विड से वेपर में बनना शुरू हो जाएगा. बट वाटर देर से बनता है. ऐसे ही आपने दो अलग अलग लिए, बट भले ही आप दोनों को मिक्स कर दीजिए, आप क्या करिए, अब आप एक में प्योर एल्कोहल लीजिए, दूसरे में आप प्योर वाटर लीजिए, और दोनों को आप हीट करिए एट द सेम टेम्परेचर, यानी कि सेम फ्लेम डाल करके, यानी कि दो इक्वल फ्लेम पे दोनों को दो साइड में दो पॉट में ऐसे आप इसे हीट करिए. कंसिडर दिस एज द वाटर, दिस एज द एल्कोहल. ओके स्टूडेंट, सो व्हाइल यू आर गोइंग टू हीट दिस, यू विल ऑब्जर्व दैट this alcohol will start vaporizing first. This will start boiling first. Just nearly 70 degrees C or 80 degrees C, this will start boiling. But water will not boil. Water means 100 degrees C. Unless or until the temperature is reached to 100 degrees C, this water will not boil. This will remain in liquid phase. Therefore, okay, if the temperature is maintained around 80 degrees C, this alcohol will boil. But water will remain as it is. Are you getting? Okay. So that's why I have written alcohol will vaporize, but water will remain in liquid phase. Yes. Are you getting now?
Yes, I'm getting.
Therefore, vapor of this way, what we are getting? So vapor
Vapor of alcohol.
Vapor of alcohol.
Of only one component. Component. Here it is our. What is that component?
Alcohol.
In this figure, I have taken the alcohol.
Alcohol.
Is obtained. And a student, this I have drawn in liquid phase. But when the vapor is formed, what will happen? This will try to raise up because it will get converted into vapor or gaseous phase. It will try to raise up. Okay. Now see, if this flask is left open, then what will happen? All the acetone vapor will, or all the alcohol vapor will go to atmosphere. We cannot get the alcohol separated from this mixture. Rather, all the alcohol will go to atmosphere and we will left with water only. Okay? But the purpose is to collect the alcohol in a separate vessel. For that, what is going to happen? So, a student, this is what? The vapor of, right here, vapor of alcohol or one of the components. For that, we need slight more arrangement so that this alcohol vapors can be collected and can be cooled back and collected. So that cooling mechanism, main isko thoda bada bana leta hu. So that cooling mechanism, how this can be cooled? Student, कूलिंग के लिए अपने को क्या चाहिए होता है कि ये इसे हमें, आप किसी चीज को ठंडा करना चाहते हैं तो कैसे करते हैं स्टूडेंट? लाइक प्रैक्टिकल एग्जांपल वी मे टेक. इफ यू हैव अ ग्लास ऑफ मिल्क, आप इसे जल्दी ठंडा करना चाह रहे हैं तो आप क्या करते हैं? आप इसे
बाउल में,
गुड, उस बाउल को वाटर में डाल देते हैं. ठीक है, तो हाँ, गुड. सो दिस वे व्हाट इज देयर, दिस अरेंजमेंट, आई मीन दिस सेटअप, ये थोड़ा बड़ा बन गया. लेट मी स्लाइटली रिड्यूस दिस सो दैट यू कैन फील. सो इन दिस सेटअप वी आर गोइंग टू मेक एन अरेंजमेंट थ्रू विच दिस इज गोइंग टू पास. सो देयरफॉर इट इज फिक्स्ड विथ अ क्लोज्ड मैकेनिज्म, आई मीन सम स्टॉपर और क्लोजर फॉर दिस, और क्लोजर लेड फॉर दिस flask, and just at the lid a hole is taken or pipe is taken out. Now through this pipe this vapor is going to pass. Okay student, now see, if again this have to be collected into the liquid phase, we need a mechanism to cool this. ये हम आप इसे क्या करेंगे, जल्दी से हम इसका cooling कैसे कर सकते हैं? यदि हम इस गरम ट्यूब के ऊपर यदि मैं ठंडा पानी डालूं तो ये जल्दी से ठंडा हो जाएगा, इसके अंदर का जो वेपर है वो भी ठंडा हो जाएगा. सो देयरफॉर स्टूडेंट दिस इज फिक्स्ड विथ अनदर मैकेनिज्म व्हिच इज फॉर द कूलिंग. सो इट इज दिस वन, और वी मे ड्रॉ लाइक दिस. स्टूडेंट आप मेरे साथ ड्रॉ करिए, हमने इसीलिए ऐसा बनाया है कि आप समझ सके कि दिस कैन बी ड्रॉन वेरी इजली स्टेप बाय स्टेप. सो दिस इज द सेटअप. अबव दिस पाइप, ये पाइप के ऊपर ऐसा एक ट्यूब फिक्स कर लिया गया जिस ट्यूब में हम लोग जस्ट वाटर फ्लो कराएंगे तो ये ठंडा
पानी.
ओके, means what we are going to do, we are going to put cold water
inside.
Cold water. Student, ये water कहाँ जाने वाला है? ये water अंदर हमारे foam और alcohol vapor में नहीं जाने वाला है. तो यहाँ पे देखिए, इस area में हमारे पास क्या है? Alcohol vapor है. Alcohol vapor. बट स्टूडेंट ये वाटर इसमें अभी फ्लो हो रहा है. आई एम ड्रॉइंग दिस एज द वाटर, एंड वाटर विल अल्टीमेटली कम आउट. तो एक तरफ से आप वाटर डालिए तो ये वाटर इस ट्यूब का यानी एसीटोन और एल्कोहल वेपर का जो हीट है ये लेकर करके हॉट वाटर और वार्म वाटर विल कम आउट। यदि आप अपने हॉट मिल्क ग्लास को एक पानी के बकेट में डाल देते हैं तो आप क्या ऑब्जर्व करते हैं, बकेट का पानी गर्म हो जाता है लेकिन आपका मिल्क ठंडा हो जाता है ना। सो दिस अरेंजमेंट व्हाट एवर वी हैव ड्रॉन इन दिस ब्लू दिस इज कॉल्ड एज दिस इंटायर अरेंजमेंट इज कॉल्ड एज कंडेंसर। कंडेंसर कंडेंसर इज नथिंग बट इट इज द कूलिंग अरेंजमेंट, इसे कूल कर रहा है। आर यू गेटिंग माई पॉइंट नाउ? What about the vapor of alcohol which was entering here? Student, mark करिए इसको, ध्यान रखिए। ये बाद में इतना ठंडा हो जाता है कि ये यहाँ पे फिर से liquid alcohol बन जाता है। So liquid alcohol will ultimately start coming out. Then this is being put in a beaker. अभी आप चाहिए तो इसको आप एक बीकर में ले लीजिए। सो व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू गेट हेयर स्टूडेंट, लास्टली वी आर एबल टू गेट द एल्कोहल। सो इन दिस बीकर वी आर गोइंग टू रिसीव द एल्कोहल,
लिक्विड एल्कोहल।
वेरी गुड। सो इन दिस फाइनली वी विल गेट व्हाट इज दिस, this is the liquid alcohol only। आपने देखा कि अपने को separately इस mixture से liquid alcohol बाहर निकल गया। okay the same was earlier। अभी ये देखिए हमने tube पे ऐसा एक condenser को fix कर दिया है तो हो सकता है इस condenser को भी support करने के लिए stand लगा दे, that doesn't matter। okay इट इज सो इजी स्टूडेंट, आप ऐसे ही चीजें बनाएंगे। पहले आप एक फ्लास्क बनाएंगे, उसमें आप ये मिक्सचर लेंगे, मिक्सचर के बाद एक हीटिंग अरेंजमेंट बनाएंगे, इसको होल्ड करने के लिए आपने एक स्टैंड बना दिया, ये वेपर यहाँ वेपोराइज हो गया। ये वेपर किसका है, ओनली एल्कोहल का वेपर बनता है, वाटर इसी में रह जाता है। सो वेपर ऑब्टेंड, वन ऑफ द कंपोनेंट एल्कोहल इज ऑब्टेंड एंड पास्ड थ्रू right here where it is going to pass through the cooling mechanism, that cooling mechanism is called as condenser। condenser to cool back into liquid एल्कोहल। सो ये वापस आपको लिक्विड एल्कोहल विच इज कलेक्टेड इन अदर फ्लास्क और अदर यूटेंसिल और अदर पॉट और फ्लास्क। ओके it is the other one, this is the pot that we are taking। so dekhiye mixture mein dono tha lekin pure alcohol abhi aapko kahan mil gaya, separate ho gaye, dono alag alag ho gaye। getting? so this was the purpose, this way it is being separated, but so keep this as the pot only, but water, where the water will remain, water
that flask will be
in your distillating flask, distillation flask where it was heated। तो यहां पे लास्टली क्या बच जाने वाला है, लास्टली ये जो आपका फ्लास्क है इसमें आपको वाटर मिल जाएगा और अल्कोहल जो है ये दूसरा पॉट में मिल जाएगा लिक्विड के फॉर्म में। दिस वे वी हैव सेपरेटेड दिस मिक्सचर ऑफ
एल्कोहल एंड वाटर।
द सेम थिंग इज ड्रन हेयर, आर यू गेटिंग? सो एसीटोन इज अल्टीमेटली गेट कलेक्टेड हेयर। सो दिस इज द पॉट this was the water condenser. Are you getting? The water was, cold water was pushed here and hot water was taken here. This is the clamp where this is hanged. ये जो stand है उसका stand लगाने को clamping बोलते हैं. Okay students? So this is the clamp where it is placed. So this way the two components get separated. So अभी आपको ये समझ में आया? So process is very easy. So first vaporization occur, then condensation occur. इतना समझ में आ गया है स्टूडेंट्स को, या किसी को कोई डाउट है तो पूछिए, अदरवाइज आई विल गो एंड राइट फ्यू थिंग्स अबाउट दिस एंड दिस टॉपिक इज ओवर. स्टूडेंट्स
अंडरस्टैंड सर?
ओके गुड. सो सो राइट डाउन अबाउट द इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट.
डायग्राम
You people have drawn, no? कि फिर से आपको ड्रॉ करना है. देखिए डायग्राम ड्रॉ करना बहुत इजी है. सेपरेटली आपको. सो स्टूडेंट्स ड्यूरिंग डिस्टिलेशन फर्स्ट द मिक्सचर इज हीटेड टू गेट इट वेपोराइज. सो राइट ड्यूरिंग डिस्टिलेशन First, the mixture is heated. You people are coming late, या क्या अभी आप लोग एक से join किया दूसरे से join किया, difficulty होती है इधर पढ़ाने में. Okay, during distillation, first the mixture is heated to vaporize it. To vaporize, not the both component, only one component have to be vaporized. Okay. To vaporize, only one component. Only one component.
Which has low heating temperature.
Yes. Which have so? Which component will vaporize? So which have lower boiling point. Boiling point is the temperature where the liquid get converted into vapor, which have lower boiling point. Okay student, this is the first step. Then this vapor which is formed is cooled in condenser. The vapor of one of the component is cooled in condenser. Okay, so this vapor is cooled in a condenser to collect this separately. In a beaker or in a pot. किसी दूसरे बर्तन में आप इसे एक जगह कलेक्ट कर लीजिए. So what is going to happen? The component which is not vaporizing will remain in the distillating flask, while the component which is vaporizing will be collected in separate pot. Are you getting these two points? So beautiful. Now when this is used, or what is the advantage? So student, advantage is that it can be used for two
miscible liquids.
So it can be used for two or more miscible liquid. A student, if the liquid are not miscible, means immiscible, then separating funnel is convenient one.
Sir, I have doubt.
हाँ बोलिए.
Sir, if alcohol plus acetone plus water is added, then
we have to go for fractional distillation. That we are going to learn now. Okay.
Okay,
and what is the drawback of that? This one, distillation,
temperature should be greater than 2 degrees.
So what is limitation or drawback? Write down. It is basically limitation. See, the only limitation is that
the vapor
should form. If both the vapor are forming, then we have to connect a fractionating column in this setup. That fractionating column is called your fractional distillation. So used for mixture having
more than 30 degrees,
having difference in boiling point how much?
More than 30 degrees
Celsius. Good. So more than 30 degrees. So such that, or so that the heating temperature is maintained above one of the boiling point of the mixture, but below the boiling point of other mixture. So this is the first limitation. So heating temperature, is maintained or need to be maintained, but I don't need to be maintained to be maintained between the BW means it is between, okay, the boiling point of the two mixture. Example we have taken, say acetone or alcohol have the boiling point around 60 degrees C, while water have the boiling point of 100 degrees C. What is the temperature we are maintaining? So temperature of the heating flask should be maintained around 80 degrees C, so that this will vaporize while this will remain unchanged. Okay, so this is the second requirement. For absorbing this temperature, slight modification is required in this setup. That modification is nothing but, a student, what we have to take? We have to put a
thermometer
in this. This is called as thermometer. Okay, this
so
is
that,
the calibrated
so check.
Thermometer, so that temperature can be maintained. Now, are you getting why this thermometer was placed there? So it is thermometer. Okay, student. So this thermometer is required to maintain the temperature in between the boiling point of the two mixture. Okay, student. So these are the important thing that we have to keep in mind. So this way we have learned what is the principle. Principle is this one. It consists of first vaporization, then condensation or cooling. This condensation. So this can be, the advantage is this can be used for miscible liquid. The disadvantage is only that the boiling point temperature of the two mixtures should be sufficiently high, at least greater than 30 degrees C. Another, the temperature need to be controlled. Okay, at which it is going to be heat, these things need to be controlled. These are the important things. Now, if the temperature difference is less than 30 degrees C and the mixture is miscible, then how they can be separated? At that time, vapor of both the liquid is formed. So therefore, we need a fractionating column where one of the component will condense back either into the flask and the other can go to the condenser. So, right, that process is called as fractional distillation.
Fractional
so, 10th one is called as fractional distillation. This is the setup for the fractional distillation. Fractional distillation. A student, this fractional distillation is same as distillation, but here an extra arrangement is used called fractional. So fractional is what? This is a fractionating column. So fractional distillation, null distillation is nothing but it is distillation with a fractionating column. Or distillation setup having a fractionating column. What is this fractionating column? A student, we have to keep in mind this fractionating column is nothing but just a setup that is going to be fixed in our fractional distillation mechanism. So it is fixed after the heating flask and before the condenser. Okay, so it is this one. So distillation means, again here, first vaporization will occur and the next cooling or condensation is required. A student, in this case the vaporization of both the component, if both the component, say even we are going to take acetone and alcohol itself, then the temperature difference is just only nearly 20 degrees. It is not 30 degrees. Okay. At that time, we need to fix this fractionating column. So both the component is going to vaporize. Both the component vaporizes. When both the component is vaporizes, then one of the component is condensed back into the liquid by using fractionating column. So write it here. One of the component condensed back in the fractionating column. Fractionating or fractional or fractional column, thing column, while the other will, means what is the other? This other vapor or the vapor of other component. Okay, I'm talking about the vapor. Here both have vaporized, while the other will pass through. The other will, means only one of them will pass through the, correct it. While the other will
condensation.
Yes, the condenser. Condenser for cooling and collected separately. Okay, it is this. So see, how is this? A student, whatever the distillation that we have learned, in that there was a flask, there was condenser mechanism. So this flask we have already learned, this condenser mechanism, these thing, this strength, this thing we have learned. This is the only additional arrangement. Are you getting this one? So this additional arrangement is called your fractionating column. What is this fractionating column? So fractionating column have this a small pebble like structure which is called as beads. Okay, beads are the small, these are a small stones or glass pieces. So these glass pieces are used for cooling, because see, in this flask, when the mixture is heated, there the temperature will be high. But when the vapor, both the vapor, in this case, vapor of both, vapor of acetone as well as the alcohol. So mixture we may take, here the name is not written, acetone plus alcohol. If both are there, the vapor of both acetone and alcohol will form here. Okay, now this alcohol have higher boiling point, so alcohol will condense back into this one, but acetone have lower boiling point, acetone will pass through this, and the correct acetone will be collected here while the alcohol will remain in the distillating flask. So these beads are a small stones or glasses which gives the surface for cooling of one of the component only of the.
What if water is also there?
You may take water, but water will again remain mixed with your alcohol. So only two are taken at a time. Okay, if water is there, then either separate column, I mean two different condenser mechanism have to be fixed. Even the petroleum is also obtained by the same method. Okay, so here we are not taking the water. Okay, if we are taking this acetone alcohol water, then first acetone will be separated, then go for distillation for separating this alcohol and water. Means you have to use the process twice. So first you will separate this one, then again you will increase the temperature of this heating flask, then you will separate the alcohol again in separate pot, and the water will ultimately remain in the distillating flask. Okay, repeat this in two different steps at two different temperatures. Okay,
fractional distillation.
Yes, so this fractional distillation contain a small glass beads. These beads are giving the surface area for cooling of one of the component of vapor, while the other component will pass through this. So student, let me draw this once again. मैं इसको भी आपको सिंपल तरीके से ड्रॉ करके दिखाता हूं बरे में, एंड देयर वी विल ऑल्सो राइट. ओके स्टूडेंट, अगेन वी आर गोइंग टू टेक अ फ्लास्क. ओके, बट दिस टाइम व्हाट एवर द फ्लास्क वी आर टेकिंग, in this we are not directly going to connect the condenser, but this flask is going to be fixed with a column. That column is also nothing but that column is also the long glass tube, or maybe your some metallic tube. This one, let me correct this slightly. A student, in this case we are going to put a small pebbles in the lower half of the this column called fractionating column. Okay, So this is what the extra setup in which these are the glass beads.
Okay.
Yes. And this one is again going to be fixed with which one?
Cold water.
Condenser. Very good. The cold water that we are going to supply to cool this. And this will be again going to collect. Okay. So right here, the situation is like this one. This is going to contain the mixture of
acetone and alcohol.
Very good. So it is our mixture of acetone and alcohol. So right here, student, let me just restart this software. It has stopped working. Okay. So this is a mixture of
acetone and alcohol
and alcohol. Student, you are observing that alcohol have the boiling point around 70 or 80.
70.
Yeah, so it is around 70 degrees C, it will start vaporizing, but acetone have around 60 degrees C. In this case, you are observing the temperature difference is around 10 degrees C only. Okay, it is this one. So while you are going to heat it, though the thermometer is fixed with this one, but is still maintaining just a difference of 5 degrees C, both start vaporizing together. So what is going to happen? Vapor of both is going to form. Let me take one with the red one. And so what is this? This is the vapor of both. What these both are? One is acetone, another is alcohol. Now a student, acetone have lower boiling point, means acetone vapor will move faster. Okay, so acetone vapor is able to reach here and it is able to enter into this. Okay, but water vapor which is coming here, water will vaporize slowly because of its higher temperature. So this, no, not water. Here we have taken the alcohol vapor. So write this as alcohol vapor. This is slowly rising. So what will happen? These beads,
alcohol.
These beads will give a cooling surface for these alcohol vapor to get condensed back or even to get converted into liquid. So when this alcohol vapor fall over these beads, then what is going to happen? Then this alcohol
converts back.
Liquid will form. Okay, means alcohol will again converted into liquid. Converted into liquid, it will fall back. So alcohol will again fall it back. Okay, so alcohol start, sorry, let me write with the black, this one red. So this will again come back. So alcohol will vaporize slowly, but it will condensed over this bead surface and it will come back again into this heating flask, okay, or distillating flask. So right, so alcohol liquid, it will be come back to the distillating flask, come back to this distillating flask. Okay, student. So this way, this alcohol is obtained lastly in this distillating flask, but the acetone which have vaporizes fastly is able to rise faster. Are you getting? आप दो लोग साथ दौड़ना शुरू किया, बट जो ज्यादा तेज दौड़ता है वो आगे जल्दी पहुंचेगा. सो यहां देखिए, एसीटोन एंड एल्कोहल वेपोराइजेशन ऑफ बोथ विल अकर, बट एसीटोन का वेपोराइजेशन ज्यादा फास्टली होता है एल्कोहल से. सो एसीटोन ज्यादा ऊंचा जाएगा इस कंडेंसर से पास होकर के, एसीटोन फिर कंडेंसर से पास होगा तो यहां एसीटोन कलेक्ट हो जाएगा, बट एल्कोहल स्लोली स्लोली वेपर में कन्वर्ट हो रहा है. तो ये जो आपके ग्लास बीड्स हैं, इस ग्लास बीड्स खुद ही थोड़ा ठंडा है, तो ये यहीं पे ठंडा होकर के फिर से ये एल्कोहल वेपर लिक्विड में बदल करके फिर से वापस इसी फ्लास्क में आ जाता है. आर यू गेटिंग? सो दिस इज द प्रोसेस बाय विच एल्कोहल रिमेन इन दिस एंड एसीटोन गेट separated into the other
beaker, sir.
Okay, so write down the process. So what is this fractionating? Fractional distillation. Versus normal distillation. Let me write in the distillation. One we are taking the normal distillation, another we are taking this fractional distillation. What is going to make difference between these two? A student, we have to write down the differences.
In fractional distillation, 2 miscible liquid should be less than 30 degree.
Very good. The first difference that we have to keep in mind, the boiling point or vaporizing point temperature difference. So in this case, temperature difference of the boiling point can be less than less than 30 degrees. Okay, but in this case the temperature difference of the boiling point should surely be greater or equal 30 degree. Are you getting? In the symbol form, ye aapko dhyan mein rakhna hai. Another one, what is required in fractional distillation?
Fractionating column.
Very good. Fractionating column is required. In this case, no fractionating column. What is the third one? Third one is that what this fractionating column contain. So this fractionating column contain
2 miscible liquids less than 30 degree.
Oh, that we have already written. Contains solid beads or this glass beads or marbles. Yes, it may be marbles also. Okay student, what they are doing? So these glass beads is able to condense one of the liquid back into the flask. Okay, for condensation of one of liquid back into fractionating flask or distillating flask. Okay student, it is this one. But this do not need beads or glass beads. इसको कोई भी beads वगैरह नहीं चाहिए. What are the example? So separation of different component of air. Okay, say oxygen we need from air. Okay, oxygen is just one of the gas. In place of oxygen, we may take the nitrogen, hydrogen. Okay, means different components of air. Different components of air. I hope you are already knowing air is mixture of different kind of gases like carbon dioxide, oxygen, nitrogen, hydrogen, helium, argon, so many. So these different components can be separated by this fractional distillation. Where this can be used, or write on the example. Here we have already seen alcohol and water. First example, the second, it may be your acetone and water. Acetone and water. Okay, the second example for this could be alcohol and acetone itself, because these two have quite closer boiling point.
Boiling points.
Acetone and alcohol. So these two things can be separated. Even the third one is petroleum component, like diesel, kerosene, oil, all these things are obtained from the petroleum. So like petroleum products. In this case, there are different condensers at different temperature. Okay. So these petroleum products are what? Maybe like your kerosene from diesel. You may write here. Kerosene from diesel. ETC. Or diesel from the petrol. All these things can be separated by fractional distillation. Are you getting this point? So these are important. This thing we have to keep in mind. So student, here we have to keep in mind, what is the use of glass beads? The glass beads gives the area for condensation so that one of the component get condensed back. So glass beads ka importance poochta hai. To glass beads ke baare mein humne yahan bhi likhe hain aur aapko humne yahan bhi likhe the. What is the importance of this glass beads? So ye beads ke baare mein aapko bhoolne nahi hai. What these are. Okay, so same thing hai ki small chota chota pebbles like structure or maybe marble jo ki surface area deta hai ek component ko liquefy hone mein. Okay, taki keval ek hi component condenser se pass ho sake, dusra component nahi pass ho sake. Okay, it is this one. So how this air is obtained from the, or how this air is separated into different component, or oxygen is obtained from the air, this thing we will learn tomorrow. Okay student, I was thinking to finish this but we could not do it. So write down the homework. Homework mein apne iske kitne exercise ke kitne question we have done?
1 to 7.
Okay, now finish at the end textbook ka exercise up to end. Please do it. All the blue questions are done. Blue questions aapke iske baad jo hai, ye aap blue question karenge. Student, I hope you might be getting. There are the blue questions. These are the blue questions. So which method is used where? These are the blue question. Crystallization, name the technique used, all these things. Student, please take this one as the homework. This is our page number 24. Our homework is page number 24, blue question. Let me paste all those things there also. It is this one. It is one part. Then the other one is our textbook exercise questions. All. So almost everything we have finished. We are left with only one topic. How the oxygen is obtained from the air. Again, the same technique. This fractional distillation. We will just repeat that. Another is the purification of water. These are very small topic that will take another half an hour. So tomorrow we will discuss that. Any doubt?
Okay, sir.
Then no, please sir. Ask.
Okay.
The student.